On the Haunted Road podcast, join Amy Bruni, star of the hit TV show Ghost Hunters, for a guided tour of America's most haunted locations and hear from the expert paranormal investigators who've experienced these places firsthand.
You'll be in the building all alone and you'll hear conversations down the hallways. It'll be more than one person. When you're in that building, it just really feels like something's just standing over your shoulder.
Listen to Haunted Road with Amy Bruni on the iHeartRadio app, Apple Podcasts, or wherever you get your podcasts.
Good morning, everybody. The Big Show is right here on the radio.
Saints be praised. You're listening to two fine lads. Two boys dedicated to putting a smile on your face and a song in your heart. As long as you buy their bloody grilling sauce. John Boy and Billy on the Big Show. Faith and Begorra.
Madam, it is Monday, July the 12th.
Right.
By here, John Boy and Billy. See Tater. Randy.
Hello.
Jackie and Andy behind the glass. All right. Biller should be moving around the area shortly.
That's the kitchen area.
He breaks his gravitational pull. He'll be all right. As they was national days we got going on, it's National Different Colored Eyes Day. There are many people out there that have two different colored eyes, and this is their day to celebrate them.
You know, there are actually some famous people that supposedly have different color eyes.
Right?
I just looked it up. Mila Kunis, the girl from That 70s Show, brunette, apparently has. And Kiefer Sutherland has different color eyes.
How about that? Is it usually the same two different colors? I mean,
I don't know if there's any kind of rules about that.
I think they only have two. So one would be
more color. Color, man.
Hold on, I'll see how many celebrities have three different eyes.
All right. Well, okay. Celebrate, y'all crazies. It's National Pecan Pie Day. Deal with that. All right, good. Pecan pie. And it's National Simplicity Day. It honors somebody. Say he's a transcendentalist, Henry David Thoreau.
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 Famous
so
writer.
You have heard of him.
Yeah, famous writer.
He was a writer.
Yes.
All right.
See, you're complicating it already. And it's supposed to be simple.
I was working on what's a transcendentalist.
Billy?
It would take too long. It's only a 4-hour show.
Well, we're waiting.
All right, I understand the concept of pecan pie and you know, people have
look,
two
I gave you the different color eyed celebrities, okay?
All right, that's good. Yeah. So we got our 3 dates in history saved up. We'll get our first prize back out and get this week a win and begin, and we'll play Outburst. Wake up, Big Shows on the radio. Good morning, Big Show's on the radio. First prize pack we play for today, a Mount Olive Pickles prize pack. It includes cool Mount Olive hat. You might get a camo. You might get a Hunter's Orange. I got both of them. I like them. Also, a cool T-shirt, I Heart Pickles. You get a stainless tumbler. And, of course, pickle juicers. That's the latest innovation from the corner of Cucumber and Vine. Pickle juicers and convenient 2-ounce shooters and 64-ounce jugs. Mount Olive Pickles, making great products since 1926. Look at our 3 dates in history. We'll get our categories. All right, July 12th, it was 1976. The Family Feud debuted on ABC with host Richard Dawson.
Yep,
still the best host they ever had.
We'll celebrate that. It was some of the worst answers ever on the Family Feud program.
Cool.
Later. All right, it was on this date in 03, a man who tried to rob a cafe in Wuppertal, Germany, fled when he was pelted with apples.
Ooh.
The 43-year-old waitress told police a man wore a mask, had a gun, but she grabbed a bucket of apples and started throwing and chased a robber out empty-handed.
Man.
You're thinking, waitress. And then finally on this date in 06, Debbie Phillips of Charleston, West Virginia, reported to police someone had been in her house and cleaned it.
Hmm.
Nothing was missing. Police didn't worry about it much, but it really bugged Debbie. So a month-long investigation revealed a neighbor across the street with a house key hidden in a similar spot outside had hired a cleaning service.
So they were cleaning the wrong house all that time.
Went to the wrong house. Telling y'all last week about when Domino's must have had a new delivery guy delivered Maddie's pizza to the wrong house.
So. I hope there weren't any police involved in that.
No, everything's okay, all right with that. So. All right. Well, there's our categories. 1-800-BIG-SHOW, you toll-free line. We play Outburst next. Good morning, the Big Show's on the radio. Video today brought to you by Law Tigers, America's motorcycle lawyers. How to get out of a chokehold in just 1 second. Now, this might come in handy for you.
It's funny, but then you go, hey, wait a minute.
It does work, it looks like, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Y'all be sure to check it out at thebigshow.com. And right now, let's get a week's worth of winning beginning.
Outburst. Let's play Outburst. It's the game that anyone can win. John Boy and Billy give you prizes from the big prize bin. Let's go meet contestant number one. This should really be a lot of fun. When you're playing Outburst, have a hurry up and guess time. You'll have the best time. You'll have a big show time.
Let's say hey to Mike from Gulf Shores, Alabama.
We'll have a big show time, Mike.
Good morning, Mike.
Morning.
Hey, buddy. All right, man. You awake? You ready to go?
Ready to roll.
Let's do it then. Jump in here. In 5 seconds, we need three TV game shows, past or present. Ready to go?
Pat Sajak, Alex Trebek, Richard Dawson.
Yeah, okay. I don't know that what he said on
well,
the first
that was game show host that he was given.
Well, that's what it,
so I said, well, three. Oh, it did say game show host.
I was going to say, that's what you said. So, but then I thought, well, wait, maybe I misheard.
No, I was like, it's just game shows in my head. All right, good. Hey, Mike, you're doing better on the big show than I am so far this morning.
Surprise!
All right, buddy, well, let's get to category two. We need three fruits you can pelt somebody with. Ready, go.
Apple, pears, orange.
Yeah, I just added the pelting part. Trying to make up for category one. All right.
You are doing a great job.
All right, I think I'm even now. Here we go. Finally, for the win, Mike, we need three things you clean in your house. Ready, go.
Kitchen, bathroom, bedroom.
And we believe you. And, Mike, you got the big old Mount Olive Pickles prize pack. We'll get to you down Gulf Shores.
Thanks, sir. Can I get a shout-out?
Of course.
To my beautiful wife, Kim, and my twin boys, Walker and Levi.
Well, all right, Mike. Appreciate you and your family listening to The Big Show.
Thanks, sir.
Bottom of the hour, top of your news. 20 minutes away, my Monday morning playhouse. Not bit of a drive time, players. Get ready. Good morning, Big Show's on the radio, Monday, July 12th, and it was on this date, 1969, the Ballad of John and Yoko by the Beatles. They were still together when they did this tune. Peaked at number 8 on the pop singles chart. In honor of the ballad of John and Yoko, here's something you might want to check out.
John Lennon. His music changed the world. Now you can hear previously unknown recordings from one of the greatest names of the history of rock and roll. It's the Lost Lennon Party Tapes.
Hey, George. Name a dog with wings.
I don't know.
Linda McCartney.
You'll hear rare glimpses into the mind of John Lennon when he didn't know the tape recorder was running.
Yoko, Yoko, come over here, love. Pull me finger.
Plus, for the first time anywhere, you'll hear extremely rare, unreleased versions of Beatles songs and rare studio outtakes.
Let's write a song about dropping some acid, and then when they ask, we'll deny the whole thing.
What do you think?
The Lost Lennon Party Tapes.
Number one. Wait. Cut. At this rate, I'm going to have to do it 8 more times before I get it right. Let's try something else.
Coming soon to a rock and roll radio station near you.
Good Monday morning, Big Show's on the radio, and here we go.
Welcome to John Boy and Billy Playhouse. Today's episode, One Night at Hooligans. As our story opens, William Fitzpatrick has just arrived at the offices of Fitzpatrick Incorporated in Dublin, Ireland. That's Dublin, Ireland.
All righty, Mr. Fitzpatrick. Here you go. One large black coffee and 3 extra strength Tylenol.
Dublin, Ireland.
By way of Jamaica.
Thank you, Bridget. You're a lifesaver, darling.
Starting the week with a bit of a headache, are we?
Bit of a hangover, actually. Took me son out for a drink last night at Hooligans, this little hole in the wall 2 blocks from the house. Found us a booth in the back so we could just kind of hang out together.
Well, have it a drink with your son. Ah, that sounds nice.
Yeah, I ended up doing most of the drinking. Turned out the boy's a tad picky when it comes to alcohol.
Oh, do tell.
Well, I ordered a couple of pints of Guinness at the bar and brung him back to the booth. The boy took one sip, never touched the glass again. I ended up drinking both pints.
So not a big Guinness fan.
Where's that voice coming from? I didn't know I was that hungover.
Don't worry, drink your coffee.
Anyway, no, he don't like Guinness, if that's what you're asking.
Yes. That's...
So when I went back to the bar for the second round, I ordered a couple of Killians. He took one sip, didn't care for that one neither. I finished both of those, too.
Well, it sounds like your boy's not a beer man at all.
Irie, that's right. That's what I said, except with an Irish accent. So the third round, I went and got us a couple of Jamesons. Turns out my boy's not really a whiskey drinker neither.
So let me guess, you downed them both, huh?
I certainly did. Sister. So I just walked over to the barman. I said, look, what's the very best drink you got back there? And he says, well, that'd be the Glenfiddich. Without a doubt, 25 years old, absolutely flawless. I said, great, give me 2 of them.
Well, how did that go over?
Like a fart in a diving bell.
Well.
I set the glass down in front of me son. He takes a quick sniff, makes a face, and pushes it back across the table at me. He wouldn't even taste it. So I finally gave up. I just paid the tab and we left the pub.
Well, well, at least you got to spend some time with your son. I wouldn't fret about it. Maybe he just ain't a drinker.
Maybe he ain't a what?
Well, if I wasn't so rudely interrupted, maybe he just ain't a drinker.
I know, and I wish I'd have figured it out earlier, because by the time I got him back in the stroller, I was so drunk I could barely drive us home.
Ha 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 ha!
We hope you've enjoyed this globe-trotting edition of John Boy and Billy's Playhouse.
It's like going on a cruise to the Caribbean all the way around to Ireland.
Tune in again next time when we'll hear the crusty old caseworker from Child Services say,
"Hey, big man, let me hold a dollar."
Oh, I get it. It's a baby.
It's Big Show on the radio. John Boy, Billy, Tater, Pillars, Randy, Jackie, and you listening.
Hiya, pal. You are listening to two of the funniest guys on the radio and my fraternity brothers at the Raccoon Lodge, John Boy and Billy on the Big Show. Are they funny? Are they funny? Oh, ho, 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 ho.
Summertime cooking gets you John Boy Miller Grillin' Sauce. All our flavors now available at Good morning, Big Show's on the radio. Coming up, we play John Boy Jeopardy. Somebody's going to win a variety pack of Astera Labs products. Pharmaceutical-grade CBD made in the USA and no bitter aftertaste. Go to BigShow.com, click on the Astera Labs banner, enter code JBB, get 20% off on all CBD products. Must be 18 to win. Hang on, we'll play for in a second. First, I tell you, Bill Cosby is having a birthday today. He is 84 years old, and for the first time in a while, he's a free man.
Yeah, I guarantee he's going to party like it's 1994.
So, 84 years old. And back when all this was breaking, was we brought in our bro on call, Marvin Webster.
Yo, what's up? How y'all doing?
Good, man.
Hey, man, y'all been hearing all this mess about Bill Cosby lately?
Well, yeah.
Of course you have. What am I saying? How could you not know about it? Bill Cosby is like the Kardashians. You keep up with him whether you mean to or not.
Yeah,
Bill Cosby used to be America's dad. Now he's America's crazy old uncle on the sex offender registry. When I was growing up, everybody loved Bill Cosby. Mm-hmm. Nowadays, only time you hear somebody say Bill Cosby is the man is when they're given a deposition. Got 55 women say Bill put something in the drink and knocked them out. Damn. 55 women, that's a lot. And every one of them saying exactly the same thing. In the words of my Uncle Cedric, you can't get 55 women to agree on what color the sky is. So the first case finally went to court, ended up in a mistrial. Some of Cosby's people got on TV talking like he just beat Golden State for the championship. I believe y'all got a ways to go yet, son.
Yeah, yeah.
You need to quit thinking case closed and start thinking one down, 54 to go.
Yeah.
It's just sad, man. You know, Bill Cosby had the number one TV show for 10 straight years, mm-hmm. The Cosby Show. It was a legend. Nowadays, when you hear Dr. Huxtable, all you think about is, oh, that's the dude that wrote himself all them Quaalude prescriptions. And I should tell you how long this stuff been going on. Ain't nobody in America ate a Quaalude for 35 years. Yeah, back in the day, every time you saw Bill Cosby in the news, he was getting an honorary doctorate degree from some college somewhere. You don't see that no more.
Mm-mm.
Bill's had to get back so many degrees, by the time it's all over with, he gonna have to repeat the 10th grade. But you know who might be the saddest man in America about all this? The dude that's got the rerun rights for Fat Albert and the Cosby Kid.
Oh, yeah.
Fat Albert was my favorite show when I was growing up. Only place I could cut TV on and see people that look like me, you know? And when I say look like me, I mean a fat kid with a thyroid problem that live in a real bad neighborhood.
Yeah.
Oh, but don't look for Fat Albert to pop up on the after school block on TBS anytime soon. That'd be a tough sell right now. So let me get this straight. It's a kid that sounds like Bill Cosby, and he goes, hey, 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 for 25 minutes, and then the real Bill Cosby comes on and tells you how not to mess up your life? Yeah, I think we might stay with SpongeBob. Speaking of giving advice, did you hear Cosby been talking about doing a bunch of town hall meetings all over the place to teach young men how to avoid being accused of inappropriate behavior toward women?
Yeah,
I think you're going to call it the takes one to know one tour. It's like Charlie Sheen throwing a say no to drugs. We know Charlie an expert on drugs. We just ain't sure how good he is on the say no part.
Yeah.
It's like if OJ made parole and opened up a knife store at the mall. Well, you can do it, but it might not be the message you want to be sending out. Bill Cosby people might want to take a chill pill. Mm-hmm. And hey, I know a guy that can tell you where to get one. Y'all think about it. I'm Marvin Munster.
I love learning history through the Big Show. I did. Well, let's play John Boy Jeopardy. Let's jump right in here. Odd, but so far, New Hampshire is the only U.S. state that does not require drivers to do this while operating a motor vehicle.
What is stick their phone up their butt so they can drive better? I don't think it's required, but it's usually recommended.
They do this countrywide.
Right.
1-800-BIG-SHOW, you toll-free line. We play John Boy Jeopardy next. Monday morning, Big Show's on the radio. Video today brought to you by Law Tigers, America's motorcycle lawyers. How to get out of a chokehold in just 1 second. So take his quick minute and check it out at BigShow.com. Could help you.
Or you could just laugh at it because that was the original intention. But
your choice. TheBigShow.com. And right now, let's play.
Yes, live across America, it's John Jeopardy. And now, a man who can usually get out of a joke hole in under 1 second. Usually, he's John Moore.
And say hey to Greg out of Lyman, South Carolina. Good morning, Greg.
Good morning, John Boy.
Good morning. Hi, man, you first up. Let's see what you got. Saying it's odd, but so far New Hampshire is the only U.S. state that does not require drivers to do this while operating a motor vehicle.
Wear a seatbelt.
Is it wear a seatbelt? Yes, it is. Can you believe that?
Yes. I mean, because I wrote the question and I look at it now, I'm like, well, what else could it be? A garter?
You know, the state motto is live free or die. Maybe it's a choice. You can do either one.
Yeah. This is what I get for writing Jeopardy questions with bourbon.
Well, you just, because you thought it was too easy, what else could it
well,
be besides seatbelts?
Well, apparently, when I'm under the influence, that's a really
that's
hard question.
That's a tough question.
Yeah.
All right. Well, keep up the great work, Eric.
Thank you.
Drunky.
Not drunky.
Hey, Greg. You got the big old Astera Labs products variety pack headed down to Lyman's for you.
Well, thank you. Thank you.
All right.
I'd like to give a shout out to all the servicemen across the country.
Well, all right, Greg. We appreciate you, buddy. Hang on for Jackie.
All right. Thank you.
Bottom of the hour, top of your news. Right on the other side, our time capsule, but it's July the 12th. It was about 20 minutes away. Brand new episode of Life with Carl.
This is the award-winning John Boy and Billy Big Show. The South's number one export.
Hello, Red Hot Town Incorporated.
Hey, this is Mr. Pesto.
No, this is.
Hey, John Boy and Billy here.
Well, excuse me while I boogaloo.
I see you're starting off the new year with that winning attitude.
Huh? That hurts coming from you guys. What have you had so far this year, a four-day week and a one-day week?
Hey, I was sick.
That's not what I heard.
Still, it's true. Man, that's the sickest I've been in probably 5 years.
Right. Hey, listen, if you want me to sit here and help you work out your story, fine. It sounds like you need the practice.
Okay, fine. Don't believe me. But I know the truth.
Ooh, hey, that's not bad. You know, you might just pull this thing off after all.
Whatever. Hey, can we speak to Murray, please?
Sure, why not? Hey, do that moral indignation thing for him. He'll love it.
See y'all.
Okay, hold on, Chuckles. Hey, Murray, line two. It's the De Niro twins. I think they're ready for a little improv. What? No, Goofus, it's Jimbo and Bobby. Pick it up. He'll be right with you.
Thank you.
Hello, Jimbo.
Murray.
Love you. Mean it. Hey, babe, I think the plan is working great so far.
What plan?
The great Jimbo and Bobby holdout. You guys are doing great. Another 4 or 5 days of this, we're going to be sitting pretty.
Four or five days of what?
You know, the sick thing.
Murray, I really had a sick thing.
That's it. Sell it, baby. I tell you, by the end of the week, management is going to be begging us to renegotiate.
Renegotiate? Murray, what in the world are you talking about?
Ooh, that's good, too. Very believable.
Murray, did you think us being out of work was some kind of a scam?
Amazed. Jimbo, I got to tell you. You are really coming along as an actor. This Jimbo and Bobby movie thing might have a shot after all. Not that I ever had any doubts about that. So are you keeping in touch with Bobby?
Yeah, he's sitting here right now.
Great. Have you guys been working on your list of demands? Hey, just so you know, I called the president of the company and threw a few out there last week.
You what? Without even talking to us, Murray, I can't believe this. Are you out of your mind?
Now, the four-day work week is going to be a tough one. But I think we might be able to get them to pop for a company car. Midsize. But if you guys stay at home for a few more days, we might bump them up to a Tahoe or a Suburban.
Murray, I really was sick. Did you say a Tahoe?
It's possible.
Leather?
Jimbo, let's not get crazy.
Hey, wait a minute. You're getting all confused, man. Look, Murray, we're not doing a holdout to get a new contract.
Hey, look, it doesn't really matter. As long as you guys stay out of work, my plan is going along perfectly.
Murray, we're at work.
When?
Right now.
Uh-oh. Looks like you bumped yourself back down to a midsize.
Look, don't try to cut a new deal for us. We like the one we're in now just fine, so don't screw it up.
Screw it up? Jimbo, I'm wounded. That almost sounds like you don't trust me.
Well, we don't.
Ow, there it goes again. Look, who got you the Jimbo and Bobby album deal?
That would be Ed, our business manager.
Oh. Well, who got you the radio network deal?
That'd be Ed.
Oh, yeah. Who got you the deal for the Jimbo and Bobby movie?
Well, nobody yet.
Ah, but see, that one has been my baby right from day one.
And how's that going, by the way?
Great. We just need a few more pieces for the puzzle to fall into place.
Like what?
Well, let's see. Let me check my list. We need a script, a director, a distributor... And a cast. Uh-huh. Yeah, let's see Ed, the business manager, make that kind of progress, huh? Hey, listen, babe, I got to run. Are you sure you feel okay? Any congestion, body aches, fever?
I'm fine.
How's Bobby? Now, you know, sometimes these things work their way through a close-knit group like yours.
He's fine, too.
Really? Gee, that's a shame. But I think I can make it work. Hey, listen, let's do the lunch thing.
You mean today?
Well, I was thinking more like a week from Thursday.
A week from Thursday?
Hey, there's always a chance you might still be contagious. But I am looking forward to it, really. So have your machine call my machine. And give my love to Bobby.
That's Billy.
Him too. And Jimbo?
What?
Call me.
John Boy and Billy.
If you can't beat 'em, join 'em.
Morning radio done right.
Good morning, Big Show's on the radio. Monday morning, July the 12th. And they said this wouldn't get picked up for a second season. Let's see the latest episode. All right, hit it.
It's time once again for Life with Carl.
brought to you by the makers of Hargraves Potted Meat. Chock full of peckers and lips since 1933.
Can I help you?
It's me, Carl. I brought you lunch. I knowed you was busy helping Mr. Crawford at the drugstore. I thought it'd be a nice surprise. It's what good girlfriends do.
Mmm. Potted meat on a roll. French fries from the Frosty Cream. Mmm. Right nice of you.
It was a long walk from the dollar store over to Frosty Cream and back over here. But I don't mind.
All of that walking must have made your...
feet hurt, yeah. I'm in pain as we speak.
Well, take a load off. I'll get you some aspirin.
Anything interesting happened today?
Well, you remember old Miss Carpenter?
Yeah.
Well, she's getting married to Burles Wheelock.
Mr. Wheelock? Isn't he the one that smells like mothballs and tuna water?
Yes, sir. I smelt him when them two come in here today. They went up to Mr. Carpenter at the pharmacy counter there and told him they's getting married.
How about that? I guess they're young at heart.
Yep, and old everywhere else from what I hear. Mr. Wheelock says, you sell that heart medicine? Mr. Carpenter said, of course we do. Then he says, do you sell medicine for circulation? Mr. Carpenter says, all kinds. Mr. Wheelock says, how about rheumatiz medicine? Mr. Carpenter says, we got that too. How about that there Viagra? Mr. Carpenter said, yeah, we got that.
I always knowed Mr. Wheelock was horn dog.
Mr. Wheelock says, you got anything for memory and the like? Mr. Carpenter said, yes, sir, we do. How's about them vitamins and sleeping pills? Mr. Carpenter said, we got plenty in stock.
Old people have a lot of problems.
Yes, sir.
Well, did they wind up getting all that stuff?
No, ma'am. They just looking for some place to register for wedding gifts.
Life with Carl is filmed before a live studio audience.
What's need that Viagra for? What's need that Viagra for?
Closed captioning is made possible by reading the words scrolling across the bottom of your screen.
Good morning, everybody. The Big Show is on the radio. Still a lot more coming at you. Hey, 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 listen up. My name is Matt Foley. I'm a motivational speaker. I am 35 years old. I am thrice divorced. And every morning I listen to John Boy and Billy on the Big Show when I wake up in a van down by the river. Go on and laugh. At least the radio works. Monday morning, Big Show's on the radio. And during your busy work week, if you can't hear all of the Big Show, we have got that figured out for the John Boy Billy's Late Risers podcast. It drops every weekday before high noon Eastern. You go to thebigshow.com, click right on it, and you can like it, and it will be automatically downloaded to your devices.
That's right. Follow it, actually, but...
You, yes. Oh, yeah, you follow it.
Yeah, follow, subscribe, whatever, wherever you're
Yeah, we hope you like it, too. But yeah.
Wherever you get your podcast from, you know, just check the thing so that it'll download automatically.
All right.
At no cost.
Yeah, absolutely free. Mm-hmm. And, man, we have had, so far, downloads over 1,750,000. You guys have been listening in 122 countries.
Yeah. Right now, we're averaging around 780,000 downloads for the year, And if you do the math on that, it'll work like you could. Then it'll work out to around 130,000 downloads per month.
Uh-huh.
So by the end of August, with your help, listeners.
We hit our second goal
of 2 million.
Yeah. All right. Cool, man. We appreciate y'all. Listen, just let friends and family, you got family, friends, in the military around the world. This way they can keep up with the big show. Back home, what's going on, man?
Right, and as I said on the podcast that we aired for, or gave us a podcast on Monday, a special programming note, if you are in the military, go to thebigshow.com, scroll to the very bottom of the page where it says contact, hit that, and let us know where you're stationed, your name and rank, or any of the information that's allowed for you to give to us, and we'll give you a shout-out on the show.
All right, cool. All right, so start off going to thebigshow.com, the easy way to get it. It's just click on the podcast.
Yep.
Right. All right, good. John Boy Billy's Late Risers Podcast. Good morning, Big Show's on the radio. Coming up, the easiest way for you to get a summertime prize pack is a current events quiz. Take C. Get a Liquid Performance automotive cleaning and detailing kit in the John Boy and Billy bucket. Liquid Performance products available at your local Napa Auto Parts store. You can also go to BigShow.com, click on the Liquid Performance banner, get 20% off all products. Just enter code JBB at checkout. All right, well, we're talking about earlier today. Was on this date, 1969, the Ballad of John and Yoko by the Beatles peaked at number 8 on the pop singles chart. Luckily, then, Yoko wasn't singing on the Beatles song.
Yeah.
But, yeah, what if they would get together? Oh, here's something from the archives of the Big Show.
All right. Hillary? Hello, Hillary. Down here a little. Give it a shot. All right, this is rough, everybody. Here we go. One, two, three. Boy, the way McCartney played,
song that made a hit parade.
All us guys, we had it made. Those were the days.
George and Ringo all joined in.
We killed them on Ed Sullivan. Mister, we could use a hit like Sergeant Pepper again. Skirts were short and hair was long.
Everybody loved your song.
I don't know just what went wrong. Those were the days. All right, it's rough, but there may be something there.
Yeah. I thought he got another hit on their head.
We're still trying to authenticate that one for sure, by the way.
Yoko is Edith Bunker. I don't know. It works. All right. Good stuff. Well, let's play the current events quiz. Bentley, what are we dealing with?
A former government official who used to be a hardliner on federal drug policy has a different outlook now.
All right. 1-800-BIG-SHOW. You toll free line across America. You take C. You will win. We play next.
It's Willie D.
Baseball.
Here to share some new info about our new podcast, Ghetto Boys Reloaded. Each and every week, we bring to you episodes featuring some of the most iconic figures in hip-hop, politics, entertainment, and more. You don't want to miss it. Each and every Monday, listen to the Ghetto Boys Reloaded podcast on the Black Effect Podcast Network, the iHeartRadio app, Apple Podcast, or wherever you listen to podcasts.
Hey everyone, I'm Gigi Good.
And I'm Wembley Sewell.
And together, we are hosting the official companion podcast for the HBO Max original series, Generation.
The series was created by 18-year-old Zelda Barnes and her father, director Daniel Barnes, and it follows a group of high school teenagers coming to terms with their identity and sexuality. In Generation, the podcast, Gigi and I are going to chat with the show's actors and writers, ultimately peeling back the many layers of the most complex and evolved generation ever.
Oh, absolutely. And as personal fans of the series, we could not be more excited to chat with its creators and most important contributors in this new companion podcast from HBO Max and iHeartRadio. Listen to Generation, the podcast on the iHeartRadio app, Apple Podcasts, or wherever you get your podcasts.
Good morning. Big Show's on the radio. Rolling through you Monday. Video today brought to you by Law Tigers, America's motorcycle lawyers. How to get out of a chokehold in just 1 second. It's guaranteed to work every time.
I don't know. I think it will. Yeah. I mean, at first you laugh because they're just pranking the guy, but then you go, hey, wait a minute.
Well, check it out. See the secret at thebigshow.com. And right now, Pimp Squad.
Ready? Okay. Comb your hair and take a whiz. It's time for the current event quiz.
And we got Randy out of Evansville, Indiana, up here. Good morning, Randy.
Good morning to you guys.
Hey, man, glad you made it in here. Randy, you listen to Biddley and win this big old prize pack.
Well, retired U.S. Congressman and former Speaker of the House John Boehner has joined the board of directors of a company called Acreage Holdings. It's a farming corporation, and what they farm is marijuana. It's a big change for Boehner, who was staunchly anti-drug during his time in Washington. He says he now supports medical marijuana for chronic pain, PTSD, and the discomfort of cancer treatments. And he's apparently mellowed on the idea of legal weed for recreational purposes, too. Boehner tells Bloomberg News, A, I've always been a proponent of individual liberty. B, I see marijuana as a personal choice like alcohol. Or C, when I said I hate people who take drugs, I meant the TSA guys at the airport.
What'd you say, Randy?
I have to say C on that one.
There you go.
Hey, Randy, you got the Liquid Performance Automotive Cleaning and Detailing Kit. We'll get it to you over in Evansville.
Thank you much, and you guys have a good one.
You too, my boy. Hang on for Jackie. Bottom of the hour, top of your news. Was about 20 minutes away, and we'll act side. Good Monday morning. Big Show's on the radio. Here's July the 12th. Earlier this morning, we learned it was on this date in 1976. The Family Feud debuted on ABC with host Richard Dawson. Right then. And as always, we can go back in the Big Show archives and find some history on about anything. Let's do this.
Time for the all-time worst answers on Family Feud. Billy will be playing, oh, what's his name from Hogan's Heroes?
No, actually, I prefer to do Ray Combs, the replacement host who killed himself a couple years ago.
Okay.
And if you hear some of these answers, you'll know why.
And I'll be playing the dumb answer person.
All right.
The all-time worst answers on Family Feud.
All right, here we go. Name something a blind person might use.
A sword.
Name a song with moon in the title.
Blue suede moon. These are actual answers.
Name a bird with a long neck.
Naomi Campbell.
I think that was the week that Austin Powers was the celebrity guest. Name a famous brother and sister.
Bonnie and Clyde.
You know, some of these, I don't picture the rest of the family going, good answer, good answer. Name a very dangerous race.
The Arabs.
Name an item of clothing that might have been worn by the Three Musketeers.
A horse.
Name something that floats in the bath.
Water.
Good answer. Good answer. Name something you wear on the beach.
A deck chair. I've actually done that before.
Yeah, you just had a little trouble getting out of it that time. I remember that. Name a famous cowboy.
Buck Rogers.
good answer.
Name a number you have to memorize.
7.
That's probably my favorite right there.
Something you do before you go to bed.
Sleep. Can't you say, you stupid, what are you doing to answer that?
Well, that's true in your case.
Yeah.
Something you put on walls.
Roofs.
Something in the garden that's green.
The shed.
Ooh.
Maybe they had a green shed. I don't know.
All right. Now, name something that flies and doesn't have an engine.
A bicycle with wings.
Name something you might be allergic to.
Skiing. All-time worst answers on Family Feud is what we're doing if you're just tuning in.
Something a cat does.
Goes to the toilet.
Something you might do in the bathroom.
Decorate.
Name an animal you might see at the zoo.
A dog.
What zoo is this guy going to? Something you associate with the police.
Pigs.
Stapes. Name a sign of the zodiac.
April.
Name a famous Scotsman.
Jock.
Name another famous Scotsman.
Vinnie Jones.
I don't know. Something with a hole in it.
A window.
A non-living object with legs.
A plant.
Good answer.
Were you ever actually on the Family Feud, by the way?
I could have been.
Okay. A domestic animal.
A leopard.
A part of the body beginning with N.
Me.
A way of cooking fish.
Cod.
And finally, something you open other than a door.
Your bowels. Yeah! Who looks foolish now, Cheryl?
That would be dumb answer guy.
Thank you. Good Monday morning, Big Show's on the radio. It's time to act like.
Yo, what's up? Out, Patrick, out. Don't come in here with Pearl after you run through the sprinkler and shake off. Get out, go outside and do that.
Welcome to Axe Ike. A place to go for all the 411 you need for all your, what you call intrapersonal relationship-acy. Dig this. Dear Mr. Turner, I have followed your advice for a long time now. However, I find myself in a situation only you can help with. Several months ago, I stumbled on a group of older women celebrating a divorce. I had never commingled with a pack of cougars before, but all I can say is, damn. It was a life-changing experience. She had 3 rules, no names, no numbers, and one night only. She rocked my world. From that day, I've compared every woman to my mystery hookup. No one ever came close until a few weeks ago. I met a young girl, and she has it all. Easy on the eyes, smart, tight body, and wild. I put wild the emphasis on just because. Well, last weekend, it was time to meet her mother. You guessed it. She was my mystery woman. Oh. I don't know what to do. Mom was cool as a cucumber and whispered that no one has to know. Part of me says, fess up. The other part says, take it to my grave. What should I do? Torch it in Tampa. Oh, God.
Dear Torture, me a second to catch my breath here, brother. Did you really just ask me what should I do? Really? Brother, if I was you, I would go out and play the lottery. I'd get into the stock market and invest in cryptocurrency right now. You have done struck the booty bonanza. The gigolo jackpot, the skank sweepstaculous. What should you do? What's the matter with you, boy? Is you stupid? Oh, Lordy, Lordy, oh, why, God, why? Why does you waste these things on white boys? But I regress. Let me preach on it. Now, the odds of this ever happening is a baskillion to one. To ignoramus, the strokity of luck would be the epitome of foolishosity. Does you know how many of your friends would beat your dumb cracker ass to take your place? You live in a dream, player. Look, hot, divorcified Mamacita has already said no one need to know. Are you inculpable of reading between the sheets? She is saying you can have your hoe cake and your for show cake at the same time. You are like that dumbass Jake from State Farm. That hippie girl loading him down with them Flintstone-sized steaks. And then she says, meet me around back in 20 minutes and I'll hook you up with the good parts. If you think good parts is more steaks, what's up with you, man? Yo, check it. Another thing you got to do is dig that this ain't going to last forever. I mean, lots of stuff can go wrong, not even counting getting caught with her drawers around her cankles. Now remember, mom is hip to the scene. She is canoodling with her own damn daughter's man. She is stank. She knows she stank. Stanks can do all kinds of deviosity. She might use your little secret to blackmail you, my brother. You don't give in. She spills the beans to daughter. Then you get kicked out of the corral, and then you got no heifers to milk. The upside to that is daughter might be just as stank as mom, and all of a sudden, you as letter of the month at Penthouse Forum. Another problem you're going to have is keeping up. No punk intended rated. Maintaining two active, lustful lifestyles take a lot out of a man. Ask me how I know. You got to stock up on things to keep you in tippity-toppity shape. How does I do it? Well, I make a smoothie I take twice a day. One can of Red Bull, two can of barbecue vianis, a can of Sterno, a big old squirt of vitamin BH12, and a half a bottle of Ripple. Now, Mad Dog 2020 will do in a pinch. Here's a tip. Don't break wind in open flame. Chapped cheeks will put a pamper on your buns, up and wheeling activities. And even if everything goes without a hitch vacation, you got to know that Father Time can be a mother. Sexy mom might be a hot potato now, but in a few years, them taters gonna be mashed. And them hot moves that she does to make your blood pump ain't gonna seem quite so hot through the smell of Bengay. And when you start seeing her drinking Geritol instead of Martinsis, you're gonna start looking at the daughter and thinking, damn, is that where this is going? Then you right back to where you started, except now you is the old one, and finding the right girl now is gonna be tough. Because no one wants a geezer. No one wants an old broke-down war horse, brother. And all of a sudden, all them gold records, they don't matter no more. That shag carpet in the Broham is too old school. Well, you really can go to hell. I'm not trying to dim it. So good luck, Torture. Because you're going to need it. I gave you advice. Make sure that you heed it. But being a heartbreaker can cut both ways. Do it wrong and you're alone for the rest of your days. So play it cool, player. And while the sun shines, make hay. Or you wind up alone. And your friends think you gay. And if they both turn out wrong, take them heifers to class. Remember, you got 2 feet. one for each ass. This is our turn, damn it! Peace out.
If you want to act psych, mail to Act Psych, John Boy Billy, P.O. Box 19111, Charlotte, NC 28219.
I'm back, turn it, damn it!
Still another prize pack for you in less than 30 minutes from right now, y'all.
That's it, that's it.
It's a big show. Oh, let somebody better tell me than me. Tell you than me. All right.
John Boy Billy, big show, that's still speaking him up you. It's you, Marcel. What am I doing? Well, when I'm not hanging up on racing fat boy and trying to cure Babs of her terminal blondness, I'm listening to my two favorite straight white southern boys, John Boy and Billy on the Big Show. Oh, Marcel, just stop. No, I won't tell Randy you said hello.
Good morning. Big Show's on the radio. We was talking about the Family Feud debuted on this day in 1976. Had some fun with that, and we started thinking about all our contests that we've had over the years. And we get requests for Danny playing the Stoopy quiz all the time.
Yes.
But it's just so long that we hardly can get it in. But that is our goal. We're going to do that in just a couple of minutes, so we'll save some time right here.
But if y'all don't have time, you know, you could go to the big box and buy it. It's only 99 cents. No refunds.
Okay, yeah, the Stoopy quiz we used to play. Danny didn't quite get it.
Yeah.
Of course, we have replaced that with Wordy Word, and we'll be doing that here in a few minutes. Aww. But there you go. Yeah, so, Danny's going to shine here for how long? 18 minutes?
Oh, it's a long one, yeah.
All right. It's worth every minute. Hang on. Big Show rolls on. Good morning. Got the Big Show on the radio. All right. Hang on for Danny and the Stupid Quiz. First, I'll tell you, we're going to play Wordy Word right after this. The prize pack, a hat, T-shirt, tumbler, and $25 gas card from Law Tigers. Law Tigers, motorcycle lawyers who ride, representing injured riders for over two decades. With Law Tigers, you never ride alone. Click on the banner when you go to thebigshow.com. Play for it in minutes. But first, the best, well, the worst, well, Billy says the best contestant ever on The Big Show. All right, hit it. There's that annoying music. It's time for the Stoopy Quiz. All right, we got Danny from Gate City, Virginia. All right, contestant, good morning, Danny.
Good morning.
How you doing, man?
Hey, pretty good, you?
Doing good, man. Tell us a little bit about yourself, Danny. What's your hobbies?
What's my hobbies?
Yeah, what do you like to do, man, besides work?
Besides work, I swim and stuff like that.
Yeah, you swim, stuff like that?
Oh, yeah.
So, like, mostly around the water?
Right.
You think?
That is the best place to swim,
guys. All right, Danny, well, let's play, man. You got a touchtone phone. It works.
Oh, you sure do.
All right, well, you push it when you think you know the answer, okay?
What do you push?
One of the buttons would be good.
Push a button, like 1 through 9.
All right.
Steve's going, oh, but I'm an idiot.
Randy wants you to push the button. Did you push it? Danny.
There you go.
Well, if y'all are going to get smart about it,
man,
how big a boy are you?
Okay, look around the room. Try to figure out who screamed this guy to be on the air. That's right, Steve.
Yeah.
Steve. They were bonding. They speak the same language.
You know, I heard he's Big Show listener Barry Hobson's right-hand man.
There you go.
All right. Hey, Lee.
Oh, I think it's time to go now.
Lee.
Hey, Billy.
Don't run.
I'm running.
All right.
Hey, why don't you tell us what you think's wrong with Gastonia?
Absolutely nothing. I have family there. I love it. Unlike Randy.
You go, Lee.
I love it. I just want them to fix some stuff.
Well, they don't love you right now.
I know.
You need to practice, Randy.
Yeah. You need to practice, John.
It's right. Called diplomacy.
Okay, well, y'all leave me alone. I got to concentrate.
You do? Is that, you need me to say something now,
Oh,
right?
yeah. Okay. I'm going to be concentrating on you. Okay. What do we do, bump hands?
I'm not sure. All right, the first is English. Turn the verb decorate, that's decorate.
Decorate. Mm-hmm.
Into a noun. Hello?
Turn a verb, decorate, into a noun.
Right. It's a verb.
Uh-huh. Make it into a noun.
Make it into a noun. Oh, I'm sorry. That's my cell phone.
Oh, man. Teachers can't have cell phones in class, but I'll wait.
Oh,
go ahead. Hold on.
Yeah, go ahead. We'll wait.
I'm sorry.
Okay.
What's time to a hog, as Goober once said?
Decorative. Now, the teacher's on the phone.
What'd you say?
All right. Don't tell her that I tried.
Because you were wrong.
Yeah, we keep that amongst us. What is it really?
I'm not going to tell you. I'm not going to cheat. You're looking at me.
Be cool, be cool. Come back.
Cheat?
Be cool, be cool. Just like being back in school.
You know who that was?
Who was that? Bo Jackson? Is Bo coming today? All right, cool, man.
Trying to
cool.
get here.
All right, Bo
He's on
Jackson
77.
Is looking for the Big Show Studios right
yes.
now.
Yes.
You know, the scary thing is she gave Steve the intern the phone and said,
I said, give him directions. Oh, I can't.
Oh,
boy. Oh,
John Boy
Lord,
was trying to cheat while you were out of the room.
Oh, boy.
Oh,
man. I knew
me,
that.
He
you
asked
didn't
me
have
for
to
an
tell
answer.
Me.
Man, you're in for it after class, man.
Billy, are they cheating?
No, be silly.
Billy was actually helping him.
All right, man.
Did you guess?
My guess is two.
To dance?
Pretty.
What's a noun?
Pretty.
Come on, what's a noun?
A subject.
A noun. A person, place, or a thing. Right. Decorate. Make thing. It into a noun.
A person, place, or thing. Okay, it can't be a place.
No.
And it can't be a person.
There you go.
So it's
well, actually, it could be a person.
It could be a person,
yeah. Yeah.
Huh?
It could be a person.
Corey.
No.
Corey. No, she didn't say take the first syllable off of it.
Just hit the button. Hit the buzzer.
Jeez. How embarrassing.
Now, wait. I think we still have a contestant somewhere out there.
Hey, Earth to Danny. Earth to Danny.
Danny?
Yes.
Oh, no. This one's going to go for it.
Hey, Steve, did you give directions to Bo Jackson?
Shay's doing
it. Okay, good.
Danny ain't got a clue.
Well, Danny, I'll give you a hint. What? It's something. Think about something you do at the holidays.
I said decorative.
Yes, you did.
That's not a noun.
And it's still wrong. All right, just hit the buzzer on him, too.
What is?
Two possibilities. One would be decoration.
Decoration.
Yeah. One would be decorator.
Decorator.
Say it's a person.
Decorator.
Yeah. Right.
Man, all right.
Wow, Steve, who looks stupid now?
I learned something there. All right, what class are we now?
Oh, we're going a little easier.
Okay, good.
Woo, let's see if
special
I can
find
one.
Special ed, John.
I'm searching this. Okay.
Decorator.
This shouldn't be too hard.
Danny, stupid.
Huh?
Actually, this
I'm
is.
I'm still here.
This is.
What? Danny, you know you're.
How's it?
Danny, you know you're actually supposed to be playing the game, right?
Is that right?
Yeah. If you think you know the answer, see, that's why I was so insistent on you pushing one of those buttons.
All
see,
right.
Then after you hit the button,
anytime you're ready.
See,
I ain't played that game before.
Yeah.
First, Danny toured with Blacktooth for several years.
Then we'll call on you, and then you give your answer, and if it's right, see, then we'll hit a bell. And if you get more bells than John Boy, then you win.
That's what it said.
Oh, God, it is.
Yeah. And you'll get, you'll be registered for a chance to go to Japan, like you'll ever make it back.
You come in this booth now, I'll tell you, we're going to make it back here.
Yeah.
Yes, Danny.
It's a little late now, Danny. We've already given the answer, so next time maybe
what
a little
is decoration?
Faster. Yeah.
I know how you play that game.
Okay, good.
Oh, it's like that Celebrity Jeopardy skit they do on Saturday Night Live. We need Sean Connery as one of the contestants.
Now, Danny, after we're done here, we promise we'll never bother you on the phone again, okay?
Oh, if Pillars was here to do Sean
I told you again.
So you don't give me the question?
Yes, we did give you the question. And you okay, didn't have a response.
Okay. All right, now listen, Danny, here comes a question, okay?
Okay.
All right, here it comes, Lee. Let me help my boy out.
All right. literature.
Oh, boy.
In the Charles Dickens novel, A Tale of Two Cities, what are the two cities? Now, we've had this one before.
Minneapolis, St. Paul.
No. And it's not Bristol and Kingsford either.
Knoxville, Oak Ridge.
That would be the Tale of Two Airports. I think.
Man, don't know. I never read that book.
Oh, Dallas, Fort Worth.
Three.
Pick right. One.
Okay, one.
Danny, you got to push your button. Unbelievable. Push your button, Danny. That a boy. Now, give your answer.
All right, what are the cities, Danny? Don't say one. That's wrong.
Okay.
Okay, what are the cities?
Was the first one you said?
The two cities. No, no, you don't get the first one we
said. You
have
to name the two cities. Yes.
Danny, tell me what it was.
It's a book, a very famous book called A Tale of Two Cities. Just hit the buzzer then. Thanks. No, he hit again.
Okay, he beat the buzzer.
Let him try. Go ahead.
Go, Danny.
I hit the buzzer?
Yeah. Oh, boy. Yes, Danny.
Did I win?
Yes.
All right.
Danny, I got a party with you, boy.
Man, hey, listen, wait a minute. Y'all don't understand. If I can't beat this guy, I am the biggest stupid that ever lived.
Jackie, are you listening?
I could be king.
Really?
Oh, man.
Hey, Danny, are you at work right now?
No, I'm at home.
Okay.
Good. Out of facts, Danny is one of Cobb's ex-students.
Oh, my gosh.
Coach Cobb.
Did you play athletics in the in high school or college?
No.
Okay.
Listen, come on, man. Give me a question.
I'm sorry, Danny.
Okay, look, first one to get a question right wins. Oh,
thank you.
Okay, let's just go.
All right, Danny,
like
here comes the question. Get ready with your button, okay?
Okay.
Okay, now listen to the question, Danny. You know what we're saying? And then push your button. Then we'll tell you to answer the question.
Okay.
You're not going to get anything.
I told you again.
Go on, ask your next question.
Math.
Oh, boy.
All right.
Danny, you're like the greatest contestant we've ever had on the Stupid Quiz. I swear.
That's taking a pass.
He is the man. I hate to see him lose. He's been such a good contestant.
You take him to Paris,
and you take him to Tokyo.
We're going to have to call on your answer since you pushed your button. What's your answer?
What's the question?
See, that's the trick. Wait for the question.
Okay, all right, let Danny listen to the question. He's already toned in, all right?
All right.
I'll let him hear the question.
Okay.
We actually ran out of music.
That's the first time ever. That's 10 minutes of music.
Yeah.
Okay. What's the question?
Okay, here's the question.
Don't laugh at the students, Lee. It's very unprofessional. Here comes the question, Danny. Pay attention.
All right. Danny, I'll use Danny in the question. Maybe that'll help her.
You give me A, B, or C?
No, not yet. Hold on, Danny.
Okay.
If Danny gets a 15% discount on a $5 t-shirt, how much does he pay?
Dollar and a half? No. No, $3.50.
No, I'm sorry.
No.
Brainiac, right. Can you take that one?
Yeah, man, but I got to figure it out my way.
Hey, Star Off.
$5,000, 10% of $5,000 is $5.
Danny's going to give you some tips. You might want to listen.
Okay.
I'll give you a tip.
Okay, now, the t-shirt's $5, and I get a 15% discount.
Right.
Yes.
Oh, no, that ain't right. Well,
how much do you pay?
That's more.
So far, right. His number was $7.50.
Well, 85%? No.
$5. Okay, 50 is $5, so that's 50 cents.
Do you know how hard this is for Ed Lowe right now?
Oh, man.
To not step over there and slap you with that pen.
My total price for the t-shirt is $4.25.
You are correct.
Yeah!
Oh, man.
Oh, man.
Hey, 10 cents off every dollar.
What?
10 cents off every dollar.
Yeah.
No, that would be 10% discount.
Right.
Oh, Danny, listen, man. I can't send you away a loser. I can't send all you right. away the same
no,
way.
No, Mother Nature has beat you to it.
Well, I won, huh?
Yeah, Danny. Yeah, yeah, you won, man. I just had to have the moral victory. So, you know, I wouldn't have been the one that you beat on the stupid quiz.
You don't have a steel plate in your head or anything, do you, Danny?
Oh, yeah.
I've heard the same before.
All right, Danny, we're going to give you our new CD, Radio Land. We're going to give you 3 months of award-winning internet access from Mindspring.
There's one for the tech support people.
And you are registered, Danny, to go to Japan. Danny in Tokyo, Japan.
Danny, yes. I'm going to say it again. You are the greatest contestant in the history of this contest.
I can hear you.
You are the man.
I'm the man.
Yes.
All right, Danny, thank you. Did you have fun?
Did you have plenty of life?
Yeah, we had a lot of lives.
All right.
So your job here is complete.
All right.
Hold on just a second. We'll get some prizes to you.
All right.
That means he's standing by.
All right.
Man,
Danny had a good time.
Wasn't that time worth it?
You know, that is so old, too. That was from 1999.
That's wild, eh?
Yeah.
All right. Well, come on. Let's play Wordy Word, the game that replaced Stupid Quiz.
What do you mean, so old?
So long
1-800 ago. 1-800-BIG-SHOW, you toll-free line across America. We'll team up and play next. Good morning, Big Show's on the radio, rolling through your Monday video today, brought to you by Law Tigers, America's motorcycle lawyers. How to get out of a chokehold in just 1 second. Check it out at BigShow.com. Be taking a classic beer request off the wall coming up in minutes. Right now, let's do it.
Well, everybody's heard about the bird.
The bird, a wordy word and a wordy word. Let's meet the contestants. We got Matt from Evansville, Indiana. Good morning, Matt.
Good morning.
Good morning. And we got Oki from Etheridge, Tennessee. Good morning, Oki.
Uh-oh.
Is Oki in trouble?
Sounded like it.
Yeah.
Hey, Oki, you there, buddy? Is that like his wife grabbed the phone and rang up?
You're not talking to them. Give me that.
I heard who the hell? And then
what are you wearing, John Boy and Billy Big Show?
Yeah.
You might have heard him talking to Jackie and thought he was doing a little booty call or something.
Yeah, sure, okay. Well, I mean, you could do that, but that's a 900 number that she set up.
And a booty call with us would be way worse.
Yeah.
So you're going to try to get Oki back on the line?
I say it's a forfeit. Let's just move on.
There you go.
Matt might be looking forward to playing Wordy Word. Matt, are you looking forward to playing Wordy Word?
Every day.
All right.
Jackie says. This story better be worth it. Let's see what it
all
is.
All right. Hey, Oki, are you there, buddy?
I am. It transferred to my car as I was getting off of work.
Oh, okay. All right, good. We thought we had a mad woman in the house.
Yeah, yeah, I'm not buying it.
Kind of a domestic disturbance is what we were afraid of. Yeah.
All right. So here we are. All right. Oki, your own team, Tater and Randy. Matt on the John Boy Miller side. So me and Matt will go for the first 30 seconds. All right. Oki, hide in the closet or something, whatever you're going to do. All right. Matt, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Let's do it. Start the clock now. You put this on cake on the outer layer. It's called
icing.
Another word.
Frosting.
Yes. All right. Hey, turn the channel. Give me the blank control.
Remote.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right. You got four of these on your car.
Tires.
Yeah. All right. This is a kind of tree. They have cones.
Pine cones.
Yeah. All right.
Pine trees.
Go to the blank and found if you're looking for something.
Lost.
Yeah. All right. You sleep with your head on one of these.
Pillow.
Look at Matt. He was ready to go. Wow. Sounds like he plays every day.
If he wasn't playing with us, he could have got even more.
Wow. All right. So a 6 on the board. All right. And now, Oki and Tater.
I got a pretty good dang old idea what's going on. I tell you what, man. It'll
All right. Easy. Don't get in your own contestant's head.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Oki, are you ready?
I sure am.
Judging by Tater's expression, she is stumped for this word.
Just, you know.
Oh, that's easy, Tater. All right.
Oh, you hush.
We got it, Tater. We got it.
All right.
Okay. Ready? Go.
You know about these rosary blank? They pray on them?
Beads.
Yes.
Wow.
These is a vegetable. They're green. You can have kidney.
Turnip greens.
Yeah. Nope. You can have kidney.
Beans.
Yes.
Beans.
All right. A grizzly, black. They're all what kind of animal? Grizzly.
Bear.
Yes. You go. You paint in this class. You go and they make you sculpt or whatever, and you do paintings. What kind of class is that?
Art.
Yes.
Yeah. Wow. Bless your heart.
Stop me mid-word.
Good work. Yeah. Okay. Put a 4 on the board. All right. Matt's leading by 2. Here we go into round 2. Matt and Billy. You ready, Matt?
Yes, I am.
And go.
It's a cereal. Kellogg's Raisin what?
Brand.
There you go. You might, might be made out of styrofoam, and you take it on a picnic to keep your stuff cold.
Cup.
No. It's a big, looks like a big chest.
Cooler.
There you go. The water goes down the what when you pull the plug?
Drain.
Yeah. Yep. They live in Alaska, and they live in igloos. What are they?
Eskimos.
Yep.
Yep. You put a picture in one of these. You put it around the outside edge.
Frame.
It's like, yep. There you go.
All
Again,
right.
The only thing holding him up was us.
Put a 5 on the 6, a total of 11 for Matt. So, Oki and Randy, you need 7 to tie, and 8 will win.
All right, let's do it.
Okay,
all
we'll
right.
try.
Okay. And go.
So this isn't quite a smile. It's just kind of half a smile.
A grin.
Yes.
Yeah.
This is the part of your body that's on either side of your butt.
Cheeks.
Nope. No. No.
Buttocks.
No. The part that if you fall, old people break them a lot.
Heel.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right. So this is the stuff that goes inside of a ballpoint pen.
Ink.
Yes. Orange blank beverage.
Drink. Orange soda.
In the morning, you have it with breakfast. Orange
juice.
Yes.
Yes.
You got a 4. There's a 8. Matt wins 11-8. Good run at it, Oki. And Oki, you can play again anytime, buddy. We appreciate you, man.
All right, thank you.
Thank you, man.
All right, good deal. Have a great day there. And look at you, Matt from Evansville. You're right, you can play, and you got your big old Law Tigers prize pack. They'll prove it.
Whoop, whoop.
Good morning, Big Show's on the radio. Time for the classic beer request of the morning. We got Danny Ray Teets Jr. from Kaiser, West Virginia. Danny Ray says, I'd love to hear the bit where Cadbury went fishing. All right, Danny Ray, we'll get it for you. Coming up next. Shows on the radio. Take a classic bit request off one of our many social media walls this time every weekday.
You know what he's talking about.
Okay.
I have no idea. Tater handles it. Good work, Marcy.
Thanks.
Danny Ray Teets Jr. from Kaiser, West Virginia. Your request.
Here it is, Cadbury Gator Lake.
I hate to ask, sir, but why is it called Gator Lake?
Well, legend has it there's a big old gator living in here.
I'll wait in the truck, sir.
No, it's just an old wives' tale. I fish here all my life. I ain't never seen a gator. Come on, Cadbury. We got to get out on the lake before the fish wake up.
Yes, but do we need to get out on the lake before I wake up, sir?
Just before sunrise. It's the best time to fish, Cadbury. Come on.
It's amazing, sir.
What? Know so much about fishing?
No, sir. That you're this alert at 5 a.m., sir. If only sir could be this enthused at sir's job, sir.
Listen, Cadbury, when we're out bonding like this, you don't have to keep calling me sir. Just call me John Boy like everybody else.
Are you hitting on me, sir?
What?
I'm sorry, sir. Perhaps I shouldn't have watched Deliverance last night, sir.
Cadbury!
Sorry. John Boy.
There you go. Now, was that so bad?
Yes, yes, it was. It leaves an unsettling taste in my mouth, sir, like a spoiled kipper.
Well, suit yourself. Just trying to make you feel like one of the boys, Cadbury.
Does that include tinkling off the boat together that sir has spoken so fondly of in the past?
Come on, Cadster. Let's get in the boat.
You call that a boat, sir?
Yeah, what do you call it?
The Titanic, sir?
No, it's perfectly safe. I've used this boat since I was a kid.
That's what I was afraid of, sir.
All set? All right, I'll bait the hooks. You row.
That's what else I was afraid of, sir.
Okay, you bait, I'll row.
There's no real upside to any of it, is there, sir?
Okay, Cadbury, this is good. Let's get the lines in the water.
There's a slight chill in the air, isn't there, sir?
Dang it, we left the jackets in the truck. You want to go back?
No, no, sir. I don't want to be the one to spoil sir's fun. I shall endure, sir.
Hey, I tell you what, here, take a pull of this. It'll take the chill off.
Water in a mason jar, sir?
Nah, it's not water. I took it off Rayford's desk. It's a jar of corn squeezins.
Corn squeezins?
Mountain Dew, yeah. Tennessee champagne, white lightning.
Beg pardon, sir?
Let's see. Okay. The aforementioned are colloquialisms for illegally homemade alcoholic beverages.
Ah, hooch, sir.
Yeah, right.
Oh, no, sir. Remember what happened at the Speedway, sir?
We're out in the middle of nowhere. It's just you and me. What could happen?
Well, perhaps just take the chill from my bones, sir.
All right, now be careful, Caddy. Got a pretty good kick.
Woo! One can barely taste the corn, sir.
Take it easy on that stuff. It's 150 proof.
And there's the proof, sir.
Hey, you got a bite, Cadbury. Looks like a big one.
Hoo-wee! Get the net ready, Slim. We're having bass for breakfast.
Give me that. You can't drink and reel at the same time.
How dare you question my sporting ability, sir?
Oh, well, now you done it. You're tangled up in a reeds. Now we're going to have to cut him loose. Here's my pocket knife.
Avast! Stand fast with your heathen blade, you doubting Thomas.
Sit down, Cadbury. You're going to fall in. I don't believe it. There really is a gator.
Yes, and he's stolen my fish. Ahoy, reptilian villain! Hand over my trophy or pay the consequences. Give me your trusty blade, matey.
Cadbury, sit down.
We're not going home empty-handed, sir. Would you like a nice pair of alligator boots?
Cadbury, no!
Come on, big boy. I'm not Captain Hook.
Good morning, Big Show's on the radio. Well, we've had several different things going on through the show this morning. One, Bill Cosby is 84 years old today. Who'd have thought he'd been released from prison by this time? Was it just that one girl? Because there were so many of them.
That case is apparently gone.
Okay.
It's like it's been thrown out and he can never face trial for that charge again.
But just one.
That's not the only woman that's accused of
right.
him, though. Yeah, yeah.
Well, if they're going to do it again, they better hurry up.
Yeah, I don't quite understand it, but what I gleaned from it is that they can't charge him for any of the testimony or otherwise that went on during the court case or in the depositions because he was granted some sort of immunity.
Well, what I heard, they brought other girls in that had accused him during this case against this one accuser.
Okay.
And
so,
it was something
that's
about,
one that threw it out.
They compelled him to testify in a case, and he wasn't allowed to plead the fifth and to incriminate himself. And that's why his people agreed, okay, we won't charge you for this, but you have to testify under oath in a different thing.
Right. Well, as you can tell, we're still working out the end of the Bill Cosby story.
Right.
So you'll get all that.
I bet his wife went, damn it!
Thank you, Jackie, for the woman's perspective.
Having the house all to herself.
Well, when it was all going down, we had the old storyteller in the house.
Howdy do to you and you. Claude Lumley here, the old storyteller. And today's tale is modestly entitled, A Fall from Grace to Disgrace. Once upon a time, there was a young lad, a funny sort of chap with a keen wit and, like me, a way with a story. It seemed to everyone that knew him that his destiny was stardom. But, you know, destiny has a funny way of changing lanes, especially when the person holding the wheel doesn't pay attention to the rules of the road to fame. This young man, let's call him Shmuel Shmosby, took the comedy world by storm. Back in the old days, there were things called albums, and you better believe Shmuel sold a bunch. His concerts sold out faster than donuts at a law enforcement convention. And before long, the powers that be in Hollywood took notice. Yes, sirree, Shmuel Shmosby was on his way to the top. It seemed everything he touched turned to gold. He starred on TV in shows about spying and being a gym teacher. Fans eagerly awaited his next album. They clamored for his autograph. He was doing what he did best, making people laugh. After years away from the small screen, Shmuel was lured back to TV once again. And to no one's surprise, he was right back on top. He even earned $4 million an episode. Why, that's more than most people make in a year. This was an older, wiser Shmuel Shmosby. In a troubled time, he was the voice of reason. A calm, warm, funny, reassuring presence. He was America's father figure. His wisdom, his heart, his love of family were so genuine. Even though this was television, how could it not be true? No one was that good an actor. Anyone who saw Schlenard Part Schlicks could tell you that. And while old Shmuel was a humorous bloke, he wasn't the prettiest petal on the flower. His face resembled a big bowl of pudding, so much so that he was hired to be a spokesman for it. And while the money was nice, Shmuel was lonely. Sure, he was married, but he longed to experience the love of his fans. Really experience it. Now, it would have been easy to connect with other love-starved souls like himself, but, like most folks, Shmuel wanted what he couldn't have, and he wasn't used to people telling him no. Fast forward 20 years. America's father has long retired, but he wasn't out of the spotlight. A woman came forward with a sordid tale. Old Shmuel wasn't quite the goody-two-shoes that he led the world to believe. Oh, phooey, people thought. It must be some sort of mistake. But then another woman came forward. And another. Then another. Soon, there were a lot of women claiming that America's father was, in reality, America's pervert. Oh, Shmuel. How could you? Reruns of his once popular show were pulled from syndication. They burned his books and destroyed his albums. Old Shmuel Shmosby wasn't funny anymore. The once adoring fans now hated comedy's elder statesman. He told the world he was innocent, but a judge begged to disagree. And just like that, Shmuel Shmosby went from Jell-O to J-Lo. And now it looks like they'll be putting him away for a long, long time. The moral of the story? Never let your thing ruin a good thing. Join me next time, friends, when I tell a tale about Schmarvy Schmweinstein. Until then, this is Claude Lumley, the old storyteller, saying so long.
Hi, Bill. Let's get it, baby.
Bitbox is here. Download your favorite Big Show bits, 99 cents each, 15 for $9.99. Buy them once, play them anywhere. Find your faves at thebigshow.com. Anytime's the perfect time for John Boy and Billy's Southern Sweet Tea, y'all. Stock up at Food Lion or your favorite store. Order JB&B Stuff by phone, 800-471-STUFF. Online services by Animate.com.
Any of the Big Show you missed, catch it all. John Boy and Billy's Late Risers podcast. It'll be ready for high noon Eastern today. Have a great rest of your Monday. We'll be back at it on tomorrow. Love you, man.
Quit being mad at me and just love me again.
Tickets are on sale now, yes, for our 2021 iHeartRadio Music Festival, September 17th and 18th in Las Vegas. Billie Eilish, Cheap Trick, Coldplay, Dua Lipa, Florida Georgia Line, J. Cole, Journey, Khalid, Lil Baby, Maroon 5, Nelly, Sam Hunt, Weezer, special guest performance by Phineas, and more on the T-Mobile Arena nighttime stage. Get tickets now through AXS.com. That's AXS.com. AXS.com, 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 AXS.com.